Okay.
Good morning, children. Everyone. Yes, I think today you are very fine. My dear children, we finished the air reading lesson. Swami is expelled from school. After that, now I'm going to discuss with you 4 points, my dears. First one, summary in a nutshell. Once again, we have to recap the summary. And second one, we should have a paragraph for comprehensive questions. And then we should go for major discourses. The discourses which are based on our context. They are called contextual discourses. They will ask in our examination. The first one, inner thoughts or reflections of Swami. And then another major discourse, narrative. We are going to discuss about these two major discourses and a comprehensive paragraph. Before that, let's have a summary in a nutshell. Okay, my dear children. Now, let's have a glance at the summary here. From A reading, Swami is expelled from school. Swami is expelled from school. This is an extract from the second part of 12th chapter, Broken Pens, of a novel, Swami and Friends. Yes, it is extracted from the novel, Swami and His Friends. It's written by a famous writer, well-known writer, R.K. Narayanan. Okay, DS, childhood is the theme of the novel. Yeah, that's the central idea. The theme of the novel is childhood of Swami. Swami and Friends is the story of a 10 years old boy. Swami is a 10 years old boy. The central theme of the novel is a growing of a young Swami. The growth of a young Swami. He's a spontaneous. Yes, what is the nature of a Swami? Swami is a spontaneous, impulsive, and mischievous boy. Spontaneous, mischievous boy, and he's a very innocent boy also. He's a innocent child. He's a student at Albert Mission School, a school established by the British. He was the student of the British school. The present extract describes what happened one day in the classroom. Yes, exactly. The situation is in the classroom. What was happened? The headmaster entered the class with a flushed face and had an ominous look. He wanted to punish the mischievous children. Yes, the headmaster is going to give a punishment for mischievous children and write out the names of dozen students angrily. The headmaster was very angrily reading out the names. Swaminathan was one of them. Yes, here our Swaminathan. Swami is one of them. The headmaster gave them a lecture for correct their mischievous behavior. Yes, here headmaster is giving a good lecture to correct their mischievous behavior. He asked them whether they were not ashamed of what they had done the day before. Haven't you got the feeling of shame? He's asking. He insisted on explanations from those who were absent yesterday. He's asking the explanations. What were the reasons for their absence yesterday? He made the students stand on the desks. The students told lies to escape from the headmaster's anger. Here, the students are trying to say lies. They are trying to say lies to the headmaster. But the headmaster knew why they did come to school yesterday. Yes, the headmaster was full of aware of the incident, what was occurred yesterday. So he scolded them and gave them blows with a cane. He's trying to give punishment with a cane by beating. Swami was watching the scene from behind. He was watching the scene from behind. When he was watching the scene, he saw Rajam. Who is Rajam? Rajam is a friend and classmate of Swami with pink ears. His ears are pink. This means Rajam was angry with Swami because of some reason. Swami understood that Rajam was angry with him. Yes, he understood easily. Swami's turn came. One by one, they are trying to say the explanation. Thinking of Rajam's anger with him, he was incapable to speak. So he was deaf to the headmaster's question to him. Yeah, he is paying a deaf ear to headmaster's questions. When the headmaster gave rap on Swami's back, he came to the real world. The headmaster gave a rap on his back. The headmaster asked Swami why he had not come to school the day before. What was the reason? Swaminathan tried to protest by saying that he had never been absent. But the attendance register was there. So he gave some disjointed explanation for his absence. The Swami's right shoulder. Here, what the thing is going on? The headmaster was not satisfied with the Swami's explanations and brought the cane sharply down on the Swami's right shoulder. The headmaster was not satisfied by the explanations. Swami kept staring at the headmaster with the tearful eyes. The tears are coming from Swami's eyes, messaging with his left hand and the spot where the cane was laid. The headmaster warned him that he would kill him if he didn't give the right answer. The headmaster saying, "Hey, I will kill you if you can't give the answer. If you can't give the right answer." The headmaster turned to a boy and asked him to call the peon. Yes, headmaster is calling the peon. On bearing this, Swami thought that the headmaster was going to ask the peon to beat him. Yes, these are the inner feelings of Swami, whether the peon is going to beat him. Swami thought of biting everybody dead if the peon beats him. He is thinking, I had to bite them. The peon came. Yes, the peon came. The headmaster asked the peon to tell him what he knew about the rascals. Here, rascals refers to Swami on the desk. The peon said that he saw Swami break the panes of the ventilators in the headmaster's room. What was the act which was done by Swami? Swami broke the ventilators, panes of the ventilators in headmaster's room. This was seen by peon, school peon. Swami had no chance of escaping and stood staring foolishly. The headmaster gave another whack on Swami's back. And then he gave another whack on Swami's back. He beat Swami with a cane severely. When Swami asked the headmaster to stop beating, the headmaster brought down the cane four times again. Again and again he is bringing down the cane on his back. He asked Swami to keep standing on the desk till he announced his dismissal. Swami, we have to stand on the desk and I'm going to give a severe punishment of your dismissal from the school. The blows pained Swami very much. He couldn't bear the pain. Here, Swami could not bear the pain on his back by whack. He got a sudden flash of courage out of his desperation. He's getting anger and he had desperation. He got sudden courage from his desperation, from his pain. He restrained the tears that were threatening to rush out. He jumped down, grasped his books and rushed out, muttering that he didn't care for his dirty school. Then he's saying, I never care of your dirty school. This is a summary of our reading. Swami is expelled from school in a nutshell. Now, my dears, now we are going to have a paragraph for comprehensive questions. My dears, now I'm going to share the screen for the comprehensive paragraph. We have to look at the screen. We have to look at the screen. Yes. Read the following passage. Here, my dears, let's have a paragraph. Let's have a paragraph from this. The starting sentence, I think you can watch clearly. Here, there was no chance of escape. Swaminathan kept staring foolishly till he received another whack on the back. The headmaster demanded what the young brigand had to say about it. The brigand had nothing to say. It was a fact that he had broken the pains. He had broken the pains. They had seen it. They had seen it. There was nothing more to it. He had unconsciously become defiant and didn't care to deny the charge. He didn't care to deny the charge. When another whack came on his back, he ejaculated, "Don't beat me, sir. Don't beat me, sir. It pains. Don't beat me, sir. It pains." This was an invitation to the headmaster to bring down the cane 4 times again. He said, "Keep standing here on the desk, staring like an idiot till I announce your dismissal." Yes, my dear children, this is the paragraph we are going to have. And read the following passages carefully. Now answer the following questions. Now answer the following questions. Yes, the first question is here, my dears. Why did the headmaster call Swami a young brigand? Why did the headmaster call our Swami as a brigand? What is the reason? Here, because Swami broke the panes of the ventilators of his room. What was the action? What was the action which was done by him? Here, Swami broke the panes of the ventilators of headmaster's room. Because of that, the headmaster calls Swami as a young brigand. My dear children, let's move to the second question. Did Swami accept the charge? Did Swami accept the charge? No. Swami didn't accept the charge. No, Swami didn't accept the charge. We have to move to third one. My dears, what made the headmaster bring down the cane 4 times again? Again and again. For 4 times, the headmaster had, the headmaster made bring that the cane 4 times. What was the reason? What made him? Means, what made the headmaster? The words of Swami. "Don't beat me, sir. Don't beat me, sir. It pains. Don't beat me, sir. It pains." Made the headmaster bring down the cane 4 times again and again. This is the reason. Now, fourth question. Dears, what did the headmaster call Swami? What did the headmaster call Swami? Here, the headmaster called Swami an idiot. The headmaster called Swami an idiot. Now, let's move to the fifth question, my dear. What was the punishment to be given to Swaminathan? What was the punishment to be given to Swaminathan? Swaminathan was going to be dismissed from school. Simply, Swaminathan was going to dismissal from his school. Dismissal. Dismissal is the prime punishment for Swami. Yes, my dear children, if we understand the summary and if we go through the paragraphs carefully, easily, we will give the answers for the comprehensive questions. It's very easy, but the thing we have to read once, twice, and a number of times, and we go through the glossary for new words and their meanings. And after that, once we should recall the summary of the text, summary of the reading, Swami is expelled from school, then we are ready to face any comprehensive question from any paragraph. This is about paragraphs, my dears. And then, dear children, now we are going to discuss two major discourses from this context, means from this reading lesson. Yes, my dear children, here in our examination, they will ask the major and minor discourses from the texts only, from context only. So they are called contextual discourses. Contextual discourses. Here, major discourse is meant for 10 marks. So, dear children, now we are going to have a major discourse here. I'm going to share the screen about the major discourse from this lesson. Yes, my dears, here. Yes, it's coming under creative expression. What do you think Swami might have thought after he had left his school? Write down his reflections in a paragraph. Here, what do you think Swami might have thought after he had left his school? Means at the end of the story, end of the text. Write down his reflections in a paragraph. Write down his reflection or inner thoughts of Swami while he left the school. What are the inner thoughts? What are the inner thoughts of Swami while he left the school? This is being asked for 10 marks under major discourses. Okay, my dear children, here we have to imagine. We have to expect the inner thoughts or the reflection of a Swami, and we should write in our own words, with our own words. Let's have an illustration here. Dear children, look at the screen. Swami might feel ashamed of his behavior. It's only imagination. It's only your imagination. What will be happened at the end of the story after Swami left the school? Swami might feel ashamed of his behavior. He might think he would not behave mischievously. He might not behave mischievously. He might not break the panes of the ventilator of headmaster room. He might think that he would not give the disjointed explanation to the headmaster while giving the reasons for his absence. He might not, because we are imagining only. We are expecting only. It's left for our imagination only. He might think that he should stop going to that school. He might stop going to that school because his mischievous was proved by the witness of the pun of the school. Yes, dear children, here there was a witness of the school pun. That's why the things must be disclosed, what he had done yesterday. He might think of answering the questions that would come for his from his parents. Here, he might think of answering the questions that would come from his parents. He might think what to do in future. He might think what to do. I had done a mistake. I broke the panes of ventilators of headmaster's room. Here, there was a clear eyewitness. You know, what I had to do, what I have to do. He might think what to do in future. Like that, my dears, you have to imagine, you have to speculate the inner feelings of Swami, and we should write a paragraph with our own sentences. Here we need not by heart the material or the sentences from any other source. Just we have to write ourselves with our own sentences, and we have to imagine. If you understood very well the text, I mean the lesson, easily you would imagine and you would write easily for this page. So my dears, here we should keep the things in our mind while we are going to face this type of question, means this type of major discourse which is meant for 10 marks, and we should follow the discourse markers also, then easily you will get good marks. My dears, here now we have finished the inner thoughts or reflection of Swami. Now let's move to another 10 marks discourse, that is narrative. Do you know the narrative? Yes. You are well known about the narrative. Once my dear children, we are going to have a small chart, the features of a narrative. Here, a narrative should contain a sequence of events and dialogues. The first foremost feature of a narrative is, narrative should contain a sequence of events and dialogues. There should be a sequence. There should be a line. There should be a sequence of dialogues and a sequence of events in that narrative which were occurred. And the second feature of narrative, my dears, here, a narrative evoke sensory perceptions and images. Here it should clearly evoke sensory perceptions and images. Images of the narrative. A narrative should evoke sensory perceptions and images. A narrative should evoke emotions. Yes, a narrative should evoke emotions of the characters or persons. We should write about setting and other details. We should write in a narrative about setting and other details. We should use characterization. It's also a very important feature of a narrative. We should use characterization. A narrative should maintain coherence also. Must maintain the coherence. We should use well-formed sentences, means constructions. We should use well-formed constructions or sentences. A narrative should reflect point of view. Another feature, my dears, a narrative should reflect point of view. And the narrative should maintain conventions of writing. We should use proper punctuations also while we are writing a narrative. We should use proper punctuations because the marks are allotted for all these discourses markers. If we should keep all these points in our mind, easily we can write a narrative effectively, and easily we will get good marks or full marks of major discourses of 10 marks. So, my dear children, I request you to keep all these features in our minds. Then easily we are able to write the narrative. So, my dears, now I'm going to Dears, now I am going to share the screen of a major discourse of a major discourse narrative. My dear children, now we have discussed the features of a major discourse narrative. Now, construction of a narrative. Look at the concluding part of the story. He restrained the tears that were threatening to rush out, jumped down, and grasping his books, rushed out, muttering, "I don't care for your dirty school. I don't care for your dirty school." This is the end of that text. I mean, story. Now imagine what happens to Swami after going away from school. Okay, that is the end. Now imagine, imagine what happens to Swami after going away from school. Write a narrative which should include dialogues, sensory perceptions, etc. You may include things such as the following. Here some things are there. Yeah? Swami rushed out from the class. Swami rushed out from the class. His parents asked him what happened at school. His mother looked at the scars on his shoulders. His father wanted him to go to school. Swami didn't like to go to school. These are some ends we may use. Now, according to the features of a narrative, we are going to construct a narrative. Here, my dears, you have to look at the screen. For instance, Swami rushed out from school after the incident had taken place. Yes, after that incident had taken place, Swami rushed out. He threw all his books on floor and began to cry loudly. He couldn't control himself. On seeing Swami, his mother and father came to him worriedly. They're coming worriedly. What happened like that? They were surprised to see Swami crying. What happened at school? Tell me, asked his father. "I don't go to school," cried Swami angrily. "I don't want to go to school," Swami cried. Oh, there are many scars on the shoulders. Showed the mother. Somebody has beaten him yesterday. Bring the butter to apply on the scars. Please bring. Bring the butter to apply on the scars. Tell me, Swami, what happened? Asked the father once again. I don't go to school, repeated Swami. The father asked him in a commanding voice. If Swami didn't say what happened, he would go to school and know the fact. Swami, if you didn't say, I would go to school and I will get all the information, means what was happened at the school. Then Swami opened his mouth and said that the headmaster beat him severely without any reason. This was told by Swami to his parents, to father and mother. The mother, applying the butter on the squares on Swami's shoulder, asked, "Dear, go and ask the headmaster why he did so. Dear, go and ask the headmaster why he did so. Swami, tell your father what happened in detail. If you say the truth, your daddy will go to school and settle the issue, said the mother. Mother is saying, Swami, tell your father what happened in detail. Yes, what happened at school in detail. If you say the truth, Swami, if you say the truth, daddy will go to school and settle the issue easily, said the mother. Said the mother. Mummy, ask daddy not to go to school. Swami is saying, Mummy, ask daddy not to go to school. Nobody will care him at school. Swami is saying, nobody will care headmaster. Nobody will care headmaster at school. The headmaster is angry with me. Somebody broke the panes of the ventilators of his room. Mummy, actually what happened? Somebody broke the panes of the ventilators of headmaster's room. But I didn't break. But he believed that I broke the panes. Yes, here the headmaster believes me that I broke the panes, but actually I didn't break the panes of the ventilators of headmaster's room. This was told by Swami. I'll take to your headmaster and settle the matter, said the father. The father is saying, I will take to your headmaster and settle the matter there. Not only the headmaster, but also the peon and everybody at school is against me. Daddy, here not only headmaster, but also peon and everybody at school. Cried Swami. You need not worry, dear. I will look after everything. Yes, I will take care of everything and I will hand easily everything. You need not worry. Take rest for two days and then go to school, said the father. Take rest and go to school. This is told by father. But Swami refused stubbornly to go to school. The Swami is not interested to go again to school. The mother asked Swami and his father to be calm at present. Okay, my dears, be calm at present. Mother is saying, be calm at present. Things will settle in time. This is the last line, last dialogue of Swami's mother. So, my dears, if we observe carefully this narrative, once we have to recall the features of a narrative, and we should write of our own narrative, and it's possible if we understood the summary, if we grasp the summary of the lesson A reading, then we are able to give the answers. It's meant for 10 marks from major discourses. So, dears, what I'm going to suggest you, take it as an example and write down, and then if we go through the our text, and you may come across another major discourses from other readings, a readings for a narrative. So if you will do once, twice, thrice, and you are thinking, I mean, you are imagining, you are expecting that the things what will be occurred next. So yeah, my dears, I want you to remain. We should be very careful of the features of narrative, and we should understand the lesson carefully, clearly, and then we should imagine. Imagination is very, very required here, not by hearting. Yeah, there is no chance to by heart the narrative, and we will write here as per CCE. We should think of our own. We should imagine. We should expect. We should speculate that the things what will be done, what will be gone after that, the end of the story. Because of that, we need practice. We need practice. Let's now take some other discourse from other context. According to that context, we have to imagine, and we should write some examples. 1, 2, 3, 4, like that. Then, if we committed any mistakes, we will rectify, and then we try to get a refinement of that narrative. Not only narrative, but any other discourse. So here, my dear children, now we have discussed clearly summary with our own sentences, and we took a paragraph for comprehensive questions, and we have done inner thoughts. Inner thoughts are reflection of Swami. It's also asking for 10 marks from major discourse. And then now we have well done that narrative from this lesson A reading. Swami is expelled from school. That is also from major discourses. Okay, my dears, I think you have enjoyed a lot. You have enjoyed a lot by doing these four exercises from our A reading. Swami is expelled from school. And then in our next class, we are going to have another grammar items, and some another minor discourse and major discourse. Yes, the contextual discourses. I try to repeat you. I try to utter you the word contextual discourses. Yes, if we understood very well, we have to understand very well our readings, I mean our texts, then easily we will face what the discourse they will give. No problem. Easily. And we have to develop the skill. What I'm saying you, we have to develop the skill of writing Meera our own. Okay, ma'am. Hello?
And time up.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.